Okay, hi Tessie, how are you doing? Okay, hi. So we have Tessie here, and Tessie has, okay, I don't know if I'm jumping the gun, but Tessie has an incredibly interesting career story, and we're here to hear all about it. For those of us who are looking to transition our careers, and it looks like, okay, it's almost impossible. And you're like, okay, so from where to where? I think Tosin's story is something that would really inspire you. Hi, Tosin. I'm so yourself. Tell us what you do.
My name is Tosin Olasunji. I am a product manager for Impulse CRM. I also manage a few other projects as well. So I do freelancing a bit on the side. Majorly, I work with FusionX as a product lead.
My name is Shaib. I lead the media team at CareerBuddy, and it's lovely to get to connect with Tosin here. So let me give you guys a summary. Tosin used to be a chef, or I don't know, I think she's still a chef, and he moved from being a chef to product management. You know that I actually know people who want to move from tech into something a little bit more laid back, and people always feel like, okay, careers in like cooking, that the chef tease of this world, and all of those things, like it looks cool, it looks glam. So at what point were you like, I don't think I want to be a chef anymore?
Okay, so I think my own story is more like I tried out so many things before I finally knew what I wanted to do. At some point, so my baseline career was I actually started out as a chef at a hotel on the island. So I was finishing school, entered NYSC, started to do that. Then from there, I was like, okay, you know what? I think corporate is more glam. It's to give me the time that I want. Because in hospitality, you don't have your weekends. You barely have off days and whatnot. So I switched to corporate. I joined KPMG. Then I was now doing HR. So I was in HR analytics. Then when I was there, I was like, okay, no, this is not what I want to do. So I went back. I went back to being a chef. So I joined Eden at the time, Eden Life Concierge. I started cooking again. And then from there, I was still like, okay, maybe I can do this. But the stress was beginning to set in. And then I was now moved from actively cooking to managing systems, but still a chef, de pâté actually. So I was now managing a team and managing people as well. So that went on for about a bit. Then I was now like, okay, you know what? If I can do, because I was basically managing the food products. If I'm being sincere, so I was not like, okay, if I can do this with food, then I can do it with maybe technology or whatever. But I just knew that the base goal of my main goal for me was I didn't want to work weekends. I wanted to have my time. I wanted to work from anywhere that I choose at a particular time. So that was actually more of a motivating factor. I didn't want to always go into work. I didn't want to be. I just wanted to live life on my own terms, but still work. Okay, maybe I will just do this and how I transitioned to product management. So I went to product school, and then from there, I'm here now.
Cool. I know they say you don't ask a lady her age, but like, how many years did it take you to like go through this trajectory from NYC at this point?
To this point, so I finished school in 2017. I went to University of Lagos. So I studied education management, and then I graduated in 2017. So the time frame is just like the entirety of my work experience. But then for my product management experience is basically I transitioned in 2022. So I started my first PM job in 2023, which was last year. So I got my job 31st of December 2022. Yeah,
Oh,
that was.
nice. It's literally been about a year, 2 years. Oh, maybe a
So
couple of months.
by January next year, it will be 2 years in product management.
Nice. I love the fact that you really were open to being very flexible and just finding what would work for you. You mentioned that you saw that if you could manage a full team, right, then you could do that with technology. Was there anything in particular that just gave you that insight, or you already had interest in tech, or it just came to you, or did someone tell you? How were you able to identify the transferable skills that would be valuable for you in product management?
Okay. So everything I've ever done for work has been revolving around managing either his team or like people, maybe indirectly or directly, or systems, or just like being in charge of stuff, owning stuff. So when I was leading the team at Eden, I was just like, okay, I like managing. I just like managing things, not micromanaging, but I like being responsible for stuff. I also like to problem solve. Problem solving is even something that evolves over time, because there are different problems that you encounter and then it will not be like the same way. So you just always have to be thinking. I'm curious. I'm curious about things. I like to know how things work. So I also saw how the product team at Eden, I mean, Eden is a tech company, right? It's just that
they're
able to turn like services and whatever into like channel it through technology. So that was like where the interest came from. And then I also had friends in the product team. I saw the way they were living their lives, always enjoying. I mean, they never had to come to the office. We always had to be there, right? So, I mean, you can be texting one of them and they're like, oh, they're home, or they're in a restaurant, or they're in a cafe. And I'm like, okay.
I want to be like you.
I was just like, yeah, this is actually, I mean, you don't have two heads. So it's something I can definitely do. Like, that was actually my motivating factor. I wanted to end my money. I wanted to be comfortable. I didn't want to be going to the office. I didn't want that at all. But that was not even my primary goal. I was just like, okay, you know what? I just need to change. I wanted a lifestyle change. And then, I wanted a lifestyle change. And I was just seeing that if I continue like this, it might take me a longer time to achieve what I want to achieve. Or who knows? Like, I don't know how long it'll take me. But I was just constantly tired, because it's actually stressful. Cooking is not easy. I still cook, but I'm not cooking. I'm cooking because I want to eat, or I'm cooking for my family. Like, I am doing it as a job, because that's I think that's what made me get tired of it. I enjoy, because I went to culinary school. Like, I was sure that I wanted to be a chef, but then just looking at it and then dabbling into so many things, I was just like, okay, maybe this is not the way to go. So that's why I said, you know what? I want this life. I want to be able to also call somebody and say, okay, I'm not working from the office today. In fact, I didn't even want anything that had an office. Like, I just, because once your company has an office, you have to go. But now, like, we have, there's no office. So,
You really spoke about your driving course as it respects to flexibility. A lot of time, people think that career changes need to happen due to money. And I mean, money is good. Money is a big factor. But I think that as we grow older, we then begin to see how sometimes some jobs will take your life. They will literally take your entire life for money. And then you ask yourself, that amount they are paying you, is it really worth it, right, for that amount? Could you be making more if you were a bit more flexible? And I think it's just something a lot of people do not realize, that if you are diligent and you're good at your stuff, you can actually make more money, right? And I'm not speaking against those who want to do the office job. I mean, if that's your mojo, perfect.
Yeah.
And another thing that caught my attention was when you said something about like culinary cooking was like, is something you have passion for, but then you got tired of it because you monetized it. My God, that happens to people a lot. Like, you literally think that I love to write, then you take a job as a content writer and then you hate this. I don't want to do this anymore, because now the whole thing, they've taken it from your hand. Like, it's now become this thing where you have to track the metrics and the. So, you know, you already said you went to product school, so can you just give me like 1, 2, 3, 4 like the steps you took to just transition into product management?
The first one was actually deciding if this is going to work out, because prior to when I wanted to transition, I had changed into so many things. And well, I come from a family where, I mean, ultimately it's your life. Nobody cares. They only, as long as you're making legit money. So I first decided, okay, if this thing goes south, it will be because I decided, not because somebody decided for me. And if it works out, it will also be because I decided. So I decided that I wanted to do that. Then I started researching. I started checking, okay, So what is this thing all about? Like, what is even this product management about? Like, I wanted to know the depth. In fact, the thing is, you will never know the depth until you're inside it. That's just the thing.
I hear
But
that a
then,
lot.
yeah, because people think it's just all about writing documentation. And that's just a very big mistake, because if you don't know how to think, if you're not on your feet, if you're not detailed, if you're not like calm, like if you're just somebody that is an anyhow person, then you might actually struggle. So I decided, made a decision, I started researching, and then I took the step to enroll. So I enrolled with Utiva. At that point, I was still working, so it was like a 50-50 thing. I knew that even if this thing doesn't work out, I still wanted to that career path. Right. So I enrolled and then I started classes. I was still working when I was in classes. It was just weekends. So when I saw that it became very challenging, because I couldn't, because weekends I'm working, then the class is also weekend. So like something had to give. So at that point I was like, okay, you know what? It's either you actually abort mission or you stop the job. So at that point that was the decision. Like the final decision, because if you want to further, like I was working weekends at that time, so there was no time for me. I was even missing some classes for something I just started. So I was just like, what? I was just like, I'm done. So I left my job, and then I did product school for another 3 4 months. So I finished my program. Then there was now the waiting period. I started applying for jobs up until, so I finished in October. I didn't get a job September 31st.
So that took you about
Three
3 months.
months. Yeah. And then I'd never been out of a job for more than a week before. Like a very shock for me. I was like, eh? I was just like, what? Yeah, nobody told me that I would wait for three. Like, I didn't even know. I didn't know it was going to be that dramatic, because I was like, yo, I'm running out of money. Why don't I have a job yet? Yeah, so when I finally got the job, I was like, okay, just have to, I not be sure. Like, just dive in, and if you drown, well, you will learn. But if you never, I always want to do it and not ask myself why I did not at all.
So, what was the biggest challenge you faced during this transition? How did you overcome it? And what advice would you give to someone who is also contemplating a similar shift?
I think one of my biggest challenge was thinking or assuming that, oh, well, like once I just enter this thing like this, I'll just get a job. That was, I mean, it was very interesting. Like it was a learning curve for me, because as I said, I'd never been out of a job for more than a week. In fact, I can't remember if I'd ever, because it's like I'm stopping a job today, I'm entering tomorrow. Like that's how it's always been for me. But then this one, I had to wait. So you would have to be patient. So I also had like the issue of uncertainty, because I was not like, wait. What are we even doing? Because should I not also apply for other jobs along very? Yeah. So I was a bit unsure. Like, okay, maybe I should check out other roles. Like maybe customer service. But I was like, I don't like speaking to people. Why would I want to do that? Then second one was like, okay, maybe a virtual assistant. And I'm like, no. But I just wanted to have options. So the uncertainty setting, like, okay, what if this was actually, those two things were like, yeah, challenges for me. And then my advice would just be, if you ever want to transition careers, you need to be sure. You also need to give yourself the benefit of doubt that, okay, well, what if it doesn't work out? I mean, you might do it at the end of the day, and it might not just work out. Yeah, so be kind to yourself. Take the chance. Me, I am all for taking chances.
That's amazing. I think that that's just one of the most realistic things I've heard about like transitioning. Transitioning can be tough, but it can also be very rewarding. What are some of the things that you feel helped you land your first role?
So I think I would say the core thing that actually helped me to land my job, because it was at a fintech, was boldness again. Because I mean, I'd applied to so many jobs. Some of them would respond. Some of them would say, oh, we're not looking for an entry-level candidate. Somebody that at least have like a year, 2 years experience. But then even before or after even doing like product school, I started interning for free. Like, I mean, I had friends that wanted to build products. I mean, even if the product did not eventually go live, at least there's still some work experience.
Yes.
Yeah. So I had people that, I mean, I was just speaking to a lot of people, like, and everybody that knows, they're like, you again, okay, no one, you've changed, okay, no problem. So just help me spread the word, okay, I'm looking to intern. And I just zeroed money from my mind. I actually wasn't expecting. This thing, you only have theoretical knowledge if you actually want to. So after that, when I finally got the job, there was some form of delay and I could not even understand what was going on. So I reached out to the CEO and I was like,
that's it. That's needed, honestly. There's a level of audacity you need in this tech corporate world. Yes.
So even before that, it was like a stage-by-stage interview process. Mm-hmm. So I submitted my resume, and then I got like a message that, oh, your application has been gotten, all those gist. Mm-hmm. 2 weeks after I had applied, you said you've gotten my application. So I now reached out to the CEO. I was like, hi, I submitted an application for this role, but then 2 weeks after, if I'm not even going to be in like the first batch of interview process, then courtesy demands that you're in. The guy was so stunned. He was actually very surprised. He was like, hello to you too. In fact, it's Lens Square. Let me just mention the name of the company. So Lens Square. Yeah. I reached out to Deji. Then he wasn't like, okay, very interesting. Why did you even feel that you could text me? I said, you are the CEO, no? So he was like, okay, I should drop my contact. So then, I didn't know it was going to, like, I didn't know my interview was going to start then. So, I just even dropped my number and my email and whatever. So, he called me. He was like, oh, this is Deji speaking. I was like, oh, good afternoon. But I was watching TV. So, I didn't know that it was going to be. So it wasn't like, okay. So it wasn't like, okay, so your interview starts now. And I'm like, pardon?
What?
So he said, you need a job, right? So I know, he started asking me, okay, so why did you decide? Because a career transition, everybody was just interested in the fact that you're moving from a career in hospitality to a career in tech. Like, why? I explained. He asked me some questions, like basic product management questions. Asked me about my career goals. And all. So, he now said, okay, that this interview has come to an end, that I should get ready for the next stages. So, apparently, his own interview stage was supposed to be the one that I now did.
But then, because she reached out to the CEO.
Yeah, but then people now said, like, nobody knew that. So I still went through like the normal process. Mm-hmm. So you know that you've spoken to me doesn't guarantee anything. If you're not able to scale through this other stage, nice speaking with you. So I knew things were now serious. So I went through all the stages. And then I saw like the fourth one, like the product
lead.
Yeah. The product lead. Actually, it was supposed to be six. But then. I was not even tired. So I was but I was like, oh, you can't need this job. Like, bro, you cannot enter jobless. Like, you can't do that. Mm-hmm. So I did everything. And then at the end, I got the job. So Nobody knew that I had, like, the CEO was my first point of contact till after like 2 months on the job. So I was like, do you guys even know that? Then, what? So why did you? I said, well, me, I wasn't expecting that I would boycott the whole process just because, just because I was bold enough to reach out to the CEO. So I mean, that was just because if I did not
Because he's definitely asking everybody to go and reach out to the CEO. It's just that you have to make a move.
Yeah.
You have to check it up. You can't be waiting. Yeah. I just like, I'm taking courses. I went to this one. I did this course, but still, no job, no job. I think that there's just a level of radness. Like, there's a rebellion that is needed. Because if you say you are leaving point A to point B, you need to rebel. You need to rebel. And it needs to be done, either strategically, anyhow. The most important thing is that you have to move. Do you care to share? What was your first salary? Was it not what you expected?
My first salary was, to be honest, I didn't care at that point because I just told myself, you are the one living this career. If you need to take a pay cut, then you need to take a pay cut. Because obviously, no company is going to hire an entry level and pay them a ridiculous amount of money. So while I hoped for the best, I wasn't too pissed about it. So I think my first PM, because I think I was now moving from, I took it like about 100K or 150K pay cuts from there, coming from where I was. Yeah. So my first PM salary was 150. It was 150K. Was it 150? Yeah. And then I had to get my laptop. But there was like stipend for internet. Yeah, so, and then he was even, like, when I say he, the CEO was even more particular about the fact that, are you sure you're going to be able to take a pay cut? Because when you talk about general work experience, you have, like, a broad general work experience. But do you feel comfortable in taking a pay cut? And I told him that something has to give.
Yeah.
That's a sport. Like, something must work out. So, if I want to show, and this is the salary band for this show, then yeah, I'm going to take it, because it's not like you guys are hiding it or you guys are saying, okay, it's flexible. If you're telling
me, you can negotiate at any point, like even when they say,
I think I did, but I knew that I did, but I knew that it wasn't like, it wasn't going to cost it, because I was like, okay, I was just like, okay, no, I'm gonna take 200K. They're like, it was something that struggling, like tussling for us. But then the certainty there was like, okay, once you are doing your performance evaluation, 3 months after, 6 months after, you can definitely earn as high as you go.
Yeah.
Your blood and sweat will speak for your money.
Yes, yes.
Doing the same things over and again and be expecting like a better salary. Yeah.
Yeah.
So more money.
Why isn't that everybody's dream? But I think that more money, less work comes when you pay your dues. Really, that's the truth.
And even when you pay your dues, your work is now more of like
mental. Except if you are Emi Oga, even Emi Oga is still work.
It's still work because you have to take care of your family. You have to.
And do all those things and all, so
it's still like it's
any Oga or anyone, everything is work. There's performance. Oh, so cool. It's been so great talking to you. So I don't think you're not at Lens Square anymore, right? You've moved.
Oh yeah, I moved. I spent 9 months there and then I moved.
Nice. So has it been as rewarding as you wanted it to be? Like, do you feel like, okay, I think, thank God I made this decision?
I'm actually very thankful that I made this decision, because that was just one thing that I wanted. And then even in terms of like growing financially too, I've grown financially, because even outside of my regular jobs, I was able to take like an international internship for 3 months. It paid me a lot of money. So the opportunities for me, like the opportunities are available, it's just how much can you handle. That's just good. So you can have your make at I think from like May, June, I was already working 4 jobs. So that was, I had my main job, I had my side job, I had the other side job, I had my internship. So So again,
But of course, to anybody that watches this and is like, oh, why is she doing four jobs? What would you be giving? But the
it's
one that has that is not using it, even what he has will be taken
it's not
away.
great. And context switching is not even funny because these are different industries, these are different things. So you
Yes.
always
I have
like
to deliver consistently across board.
have to recondition your mind. Some days I actually wake up and I'm like, okay, what? But every day I'm grateful that I made that decision. But some days would be very challenging. I'm like, why am I even working? Like I'm like, God, why do I need to work? Some other days I'm great, I feel awesome, I can take on anything in the world. So I mean, it just depends on what I have on my plate per time. But I don't regret, and I will never transitioning. So because right now I work from home. Even like when I was at Lens Square, there was no office, so I've been working from or remotely since January last year. So I like
And
you know
that's
what?
it's been so great talking to you, Tosin. Like, I think you shared a lot of valuable insights, like gold. And this is just the reality of what it takes to transition. And I'm glad that you did not even make it look like, oh, it's just a walk in the park, but it is very worth it. It is very worth it. And I think what better time? So, like someone would say, the best time to transition your career, if you've been thinking about it, was yesterday. Then the next best time is now, right? The next best time is now. If you end up watching this, the next best time is really now. So go take that course, take that internship. It might look a little stressful for a while, but I think that just like Tosin, you would find your path and you would thrive in it. Thank you so much, Tosin. I
Thank
love
you.
talking to you. Bye.
Bye.